Okay, 我们开始。Oh my God！
稍等一下。我
Recording in progress.
Okay.
来，昆特基服务员聆听。各位尊敬的 Vaishnava 奉献者，今天是2023年4月4日，我们又荣幸地邀请到了圣 Bhakti Vignaveenashna Singha Maharaj 给我们讲今天的大博加瓦坦早课，敬请聆听。 Hare Krishna。
Om Jnana Timirandasya Kananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha。Vanchakalpatarubhyascha kripasindubhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we've just began to read the second half, the second part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. And we were hearing about how Mother Uttara was inquiring from her son Maharaj Parikshit about the main teachings he had heard from Sukadeva Goswami. And she knew that the Lord's abode must be a very wonderful place for the Lord to perform his intimate pastimes there. So she's put a question. Now we're going to hear her she's going to place a question before her son, Maharaj Parikshit. So she begins by saying that by doing auspicious duties, then people in family life with material desires can achieve some position in the three worlds, means in the material world. The three worlds are, first world is there's Bhu Mandala, and then Bhuvar Mandala, and then above Bhuvar Mandala you've got Swarga, which is the heavenly planets. So those are the three worlds which the people who have material desires can go to.
在物质世界这三个居所呢，一个是 Bhu Mandala， 还有 Bhuva Loka， 以及 Swarga Loka， 就是天堂。那么在物质世界有着物质欲望的人们，他们就可以获得在这个物质世界获得一席之地。
But then Uttara says those people who have renounced their homes, they can go to the four worlds which are above those three worlds.
他又说到，然而那些弃绝了家庭生活的人，可以去在这个物质世界之上的第四个地方。
Yeah, there are four regions in the universe which are above the heavenly planets. So, Uttara had some doubt about the identity of the abode of Lord Krishna. But she knew that devotees who fixed their love on the lotus feet of Krishna, that they deserve to go to the best place. Yet, because of their fixed devotion to the Lord Krishna, they should go to the place which is better than everywhere else. So she wants to express this understanding to her son.
And
she wants to hear about the different various destinations of different souls, different levels of souls. They have different destinations.
他希望聆听到就是不同的灵魂，不同的灵魂在不同层面上的灵魂，他们的各自的目的地。So
she began by mentioning about people who are involved in material work.
他首先提到了那些从事物质工作的人们。
And they're in two divisions. You've got people who are attached and people who are not attached. So these people will do auspicious duties. Auspicious duties means things which are prescribed in the Vedas.
这两类人全部都在从事吉祥的职责，吉祥的职责指的是从事着韦达经所赋定的职责。They
include doing things, duties which people have to do according to their obligation, their ashram, their family. They have obligations.
这些人们他们处在不同的 ashram。 社会阶层，他们有着各自的家庭，因此他们都有各自的义务。
And then there's different duties. There'll be some exceptional circumstance where they have to perform some religious ceremony or take care of someone. You know, so it's exceptional, not common, but they have to do it.
除此之外呢？ 还有一些例外的情况，他们需要履行一些宗教的职责，宗教的仪式，照顾某个人，这些呢并不是很司空见惯的，但是这些例外的情况。And
then there will be other duties which they will do for their personal desire.
除此之外。 还有一些其他的职责，他们是出于各自的自私的动机在从事着。So
people who do these different kinds of duties, they're usually householders in family life.
从事这些不同职责的，通常是那些在居士生活当中的居士们。And
they have many desires, naturally.
他们自然而然的有。
So the destination for these people is within the three planetary systems.
对于这些人，他们的目的地是在三个星系之内。
Yeah, they're because they're regulated to enjoy the fruit of their work.
他们在规范性的享受他们工作的结果。
So they're not ordinary materialistic people.
他们也并不是普通的物质主义者。
Because they satisfy their material desires by doing rituals which are told about in the Vedas.
他们是在从事着韦达经当中所规定的仪式来满足物质愿望。
People who are practicing strict celibacy, they're called the brahmacharis.
那些奉行严格遵守的人们被称为是真守生。
And then you have also the retired people who are finished with family affairs, that's vanaprastas.
除此之外，还有退隐的人们，他们已经结束了家居生活，他们被称为是行脚僧。
And then you have the sannyasis, who are the fully renounced people who are dedicated to preaching.
这之后是那些彻底的、完全弃绝了的，sannyasi。他们全心全意地从事着传道的工作。
So they all practice strict celibacy, and so they can reach the four upper planets.
他们都是已经彻底的遵守的人们，因此他们可以去这Swarga Loka之上的四个星球星系。
Yeah, the four planets. First of all, you have Maharloka.
在 Swarga Loka 之上，第一个是 Mahaloka，
and then Jana Loka，
在之上是 Jana Loka，
and then Tapa Loka，
还有 Tapa Loka，
and finally the planet of Lord Brahma called Satya Loka，
最后是主 Brahma 的星球 Satya Loka，
andBeyond that material world, you have the spiritual world.
在物质世界之上的是灵性世界。
So the spiritual world is three-fourths of Krishna's energy.
灵性世界是 Krishna 的四分之三的能量构成的。
It's meant for people who will never come back to the material world.
那个地方是那些，那个地方的人们是永远不会回到这物质世界的人们居住的。
But for people who are attached to family life and who don't practice strict celibacy, they have to live in the material world, in the three material worlds.
然而，那些依附家居生活、不严格遵守的人们，他们要留在物质世界，留在物质世界的三个星系。
So that means that those who vow never to produce offspring, then they're granted the world.Beyond the three worlds.
这就意味着那些发誓不再生育后代的人们被允许居住在三个星系之上的区域。
Everybody else is busy in family life instead of practicing celibacy and they become addicted to sex.
别的人都在忙着家庭生活，他们不修习真守，他们在从事着性。
So householders who are free from material desires and whose only ambition is to do their duties, then they can reach the higher planets.
那些已经免除了物质欲望的，他们唯一的愿望就是履行各自职责的人们，他们可以居住在更高的星系。
And people who purify their consciousness, they can get liberation.
而已经净化了知觉的人们能够获得解脱。
Lord Shiva, there's a quote of Lord Shiva in the Srimad Bhagavatam telling about this.
圣典博伽瓦坛当中，主 Shiva 就说了一段话。
Lord Shiva says, if a person does his duty properly for 100 births, then he becomes qualified to get the post of Brahma.
主 Shiva 说，谁要是恰当的履行自己的职责，有100世、100个生世，他就有资格获得主 Brahma 的职位。
And if he becomes more qualified, then he can approach Lord Shiva himself.
倘若这样的人更具备资格的话，就能够接近主 Shiva 本人。
Yeah, Lord Shiva is speaking.
这是主 Shiva 的话。
So then Lord Shiva said, but if a person directly surrenders to Lord Krishna or Vishnu in pure devotion, then he immediately goes to the spiritual world.
倘若谁要是直接臣服了主 Krishna、Vishnu， 他们是纯粹的奉献者的话，就可以直接去灵性世界。
But Lord Shiva says he himself and the other demigods, they can attain those planets only after the end of the material world.
主 Shiva 说，他自己以及别的半神人，只能在等到物质世界毁灭之后，才能去那里。
So Mother Uttara then says, when the householder's enjoyment ends, then all these persons must return to the material, to the mundane earth.
Uttara 母亲说道，那些享受生活的居士们，他们的享受结束之后，这些人就要被迫返回到世俗的地球。
Only a very few special devotees can reach the planets of Mahaloka and beyond and get liberated with Lord Brahma.
只有少数的奉献者才能到达 Mahaloka， 并且在 Mahaloka 之上和主 Brahma 一起解脱。
Yeah, so people who have a lot of material desires, they have to take repeated birth in the material world.
有很多的物质欲望的人将不得不在物质世界反复的投生。
So among these, some people are dedicated to follow the Vedic duties.
在这些人当中，有些人献身于从事韦达经中附定的职责。
So they can get liberation when they stop enjoying the results of their work.
一旦 但他们停止享受他们工作的结果，就可以解脱了。
And for people whose renunciation, who are not fully renounced, then the path of their path is gradual liberation.
但是不能彻底的弃绝的人们，他们的道路呢是一个逐渐的解脱过程。
They will enjoy subtle pleasures in the top planets in the universe for a long time.
他们将在这个宇宙的高等的星系享受精微的感官享乐很长很长时间。
And then finally they'll get liberated along with Lord Brahma when the universe is finally destroyed.
最后，当这个宇宙毁灭的时候，他们将和主 Brahma 一起一道得到解脱。
But there's another path also, a gradual path also, which is described in the Upanishads and in Vedanta Sutra.
但是在乌帕尼沙德以及维丹塔苏舍当中又描述另外一条无尽。
That path is called the Archiradi.
这条途径被称为 Archiradi.
So on this path, the devotees travel.They travel for the one final time through the higher regions of the universe.
这样的奉献者们做最后一个旅程，他们穿越宇宙的高等的区域。
And they enjoy in each of the different stages.In bodies which are more and more subtle until they finally get liberation.
他们在每一个层面以更越来越精微的躯体去享受，直到他们达到解脱。
But generally, karmis, the fruit of workers, they don't progress towards liberation. They just want to enjoy the heavenly pleasures.
而那些 karmi, 就从事果报工作的人们，他们不会朝着解脱迈进，他们只是在享受天堂的快乐。
So they go there.For some time, and just for some time, and then they come back to the lower planets.
他们去天堂享受一段时间，然后之后呢，会再度返回。
Krishna describes these people in the Bhagavad Gita.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中描述了这样的人。
He says they study the Vedas and they drink the soma juice because they want to go to the heavenly planets.
So Krishna 说这些人研习韦达经和饮月露，因为他们想去天堂。
So, these people are also worshipping Krishna indirectly.
是在间接的崇拜 Krishna.
And when they get purified of sinful reactions, then they take birth in the higher pious heavenly planets.
当他们净化了自己的罪恶反应，就可以在更高等的虔诚人士居住的天堂星球投生在那里。
And they can enjoy the pleasures of the demigods.
他们在那里享受半神人的快乐。
So when they're finished enjoying all that sense gratification, and when the results of their pious activities are all used up, then they come back to this mortal earth planet again.
当他们结束了感官享乐，当他们耗尽了前程活动的结果，将不得不再次投生在这个必将朽坏的地球。
So those people who seek enjoyment following the three Vedas, they get only birth and death in the material world.
因此那些追寻韦达经的信誉他们在寻求享乐这样的人不得不在物质世界投生。
It's wrong to think that just because you go to the higher planets in the universe, that you will get liberation from birth and death. It's not true.
认为一旦去了物质世界的高等星系，就已经解脱了，不用再投生了。这种想法是不对的，错误的。
We have to give up all material desires.
我们必须放弃一切物质欲望。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, from the highest planet down to the lowest, all are places of birth and death.
在《薄伽梵歌》中就说，从最高的星系到最低的星系，全都是生死轮转的地方。
Only people who are fully dedicated to selfless work can come to be with Lord Brahma and get liberation.
只有献身于无私的工作的人，没有自私的动机，他们这样的人才能跟去 Brahma 和他那里和他一道解脱。
And the fully successful transcendentalist, those who have achieved the real success, they enter into the spiritual world along with Lord Brahma.
那些完全取得成功的超然主义者，他们已经真正的取得了成就。这样的人可以和 Brahma 一道进入灵性世界。
That's at the end of Brahma's life.
这要等到 Brahma 的一生结束之后。
So some people enjoy pleasure in the upper regions, in the place where there's fire.And they get liberation gradually also, in stages.
有的人呢，在更高的星球，那里只有火，而在那里享受，这样的人只能逐步的达到解脱。
And those people who are ascetics, who are very renounced from the material body, fully devoted to spiritual knowledge, then they can get liberation quickly.
那些苦行者，弃绝了物质的苦行者，献身于灵性知识的人，可以很快地得到解脱。
So if somebody is very expert in practice of yoga, then they can follow that Archiradi path.
那些在瑜伽方面很擅长的人们可以去遵守这个 Archiradi 途径。
For these people, the first destination on the path is a region which is ruled by the god of fire.
对于这些人而言，他们经过的第一个目的地是火神统治的区域。
And beyond that, there's other regions. Like there's a place called the Circle of Sishumara.
在这火神统治的区域之上呢，是有一个一个叫西舒马尔，西舒马尔海豚，西舒马尔这个星系。
So, this is described in the second canto, second chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
在《圣典不料谈》第二篇第二章描述了这一点。
Sukadeva Goswami described it to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 向 Parikshit 大君进行描述。
He said, when the mystic yogi passes over the Milky Way, to reach the highest planet, Brahmaloka.
他说那些玄秘的瑜伽师们，他们会经过银河系，去 Brahma 的最高的 Brahma 的居住的最高的星系。
So he first goes to the planet of the deity of fire, which is called Vaishvanara.
他们首先会经过火神统治的名叫 Vaishnava.
Yeah, it's a planet of the deity of fire.
这个星球是火神的星球。
And there the devotee gets completely cleansed of any contamination.
如此呢，这位奉献者便彻底的净化了污染。
So after being there, then he goes higher to the circle of Sishumara. And there he is able to relate with Lord Hari.The Supreme Lord.
之后呢，他就会进一步上升到西舒马尔星系，他在那里呢可以和哈瑞建立联系。
Now, this Sishumara is the pivot for the turning of the universe.
这个西舒马尔是宇宙旋转的中轴。
And it sometimes it's called the navel of Lord Vishnu.
有时候被称为 Vishnu 的肚脐。
So the yogi can go beyond this circle of Sishumara, and then he will come to the Mahaloka planet.
这些瑜伽师他们会超越这Sishumara星系，来到 Mahaloka。
In Mahaloka, great sages like Bhrigu enjoy a life of 4,300 million years.
在 Mahaloka 星球，伟大的像 Bhrigu 这样的伟大的圣者们，他们的寿命是4亿3千万年。
So this planet is worshipped even by saints who are all liberated souls.
这个星球甚至受到伟大的、已经解脱了圣人们的崇拜。
At the time of the devastation of the universe, a flame of fire comes out from the mouth of Anantashesha.
在整个宇宙毁灭之际。从 Ananta Shesha 的口中就喷出烈焰。
So the yogi sees all the planets of the universe being burnt to ashes.
瑜伽师们眼睁睁地看到整个宇宙被毁于一旦。
So he goes by his aeroplane, takes aeroplane up to Brahmaloka, Satyaloka.
他会乘坐着飞机飞到主布拉玛的萨提亚星萨提亚洛克。
Yeah, the duration of life in Satyaloka is much longer than that. It's thousands of millions of years.
在萨提亚洛克人的寿命呢，是非常非常的漫长的，亿万兆亿年。
So on the planet of Satyaloka, there's no old age and there's no death.
在萨提亚洛克上，既没有老年，也没有死亡。
There's no pain of any kind.
没有任何种类的痛苦。
There's no anxiety except that sometimes they feel compassion for people who are not aware about devotional service.
那里没有任何焦虑，他们唯一担心的是那些，他们会可怜那些对于奉爱服务没有意识到奉爱服务的人们，怀着怜悯。
And they're subject to so much miseries in the material world.
这样的人呢，饱受物质世界的苦恼。
So after the yogi gets up to Brahmaloka, Satyaloka, then the devotee is able to combine the subtle body with the gross body.
Satyaloka，在那里瑜伽师呢，奉献者会将精微躯体和粗糙躯体合并在一起。
So one after another, he gradually comes the different stages of existence, from earth to water to fire, and then to air, and finally to the ether stage.
他一个一个的逐一的经历不同层面的存在，首先是土的存在，接着是水的存在。 再往上是火，空气，最后是以太层面存在。
So in this way, the devotee senses.
Hare Krishna.
The devotee, can you hear me?
There is a broken.
Oh.
The sentence is broken.
The devotee is able to give up the different objects of the senses, like smell and taste and form.
奉献者会放弃不同的感官对象，比如说味觉、嗅觉以及形象。
So the devotee goes past all these different coverings, gross and subtle covering, and comes to the planet, the plane, comes to the platform of egoism, pure egoism.
奉献者们，他们穿透粗糙的、精微的覆盖层，来到纯粹的自我的层面。So
at that point, he's able to merge the modes of nature, ignorance and passion. It merges them in a point of neutral, in a neutral condition. And so he comes to egoism in pure goodness.
他们能够消融愚昧、激情，他们达到中性的、纯粹的、善良的、自我的层面。And
then he merges all the ego in the Mahatattva. And he comes to the point of pure self-realization.
在这之后呢，他又消融了自我和马哈塔特吧，来到纯粹的自我觉悟纯自我觉悟层面。
So only the purified soul can have the opportunity to associate with the personality of Godhead.
只有净化的灵魂才有机会和人格守神联谊。
Anybody who is able to reach that devotional perfection, they'll never be attracted by the material world, and they'll never come back to the material world.
任何人真达了这种奉爱的完美层面的人们，不再受到物质世界的吸引，他们永不会返回到物质世界。
So this is a gradual process of liberation.
这是解脱的逐步的渐进过程。
But Paramahansas, the swan-like devotees, they are liberated at the end of this life.
但是那些 Paramahansa 天鹅般的奉献者们，在此生就已经达到了解，此生结束时就达到了解脱。
So Mother Uttara continues. She says, even the devotees of Krishna who still have material desire, they can enjoy the pleasure they want, and then become fully purified, and then go to the Lord's abode.
乌特拉母亲继续说道：“Krishna 的奉献者，哪怕他们仍然有物质享受，物质享受的欲望，他们也可以去按照他们想要的那样享受快乐，在他们进化之后，就能够达到主的居所。”
So Vaishnava devotees are more elevated than ordinary.Non-devotees, even if they are Paramahansas.
Vaishnava 奉献者的地位，他们高于普通的非奉献者。哪怕这些非奉献者是已经达到了 Paramahansa 层面。
And a devotee who has a lot of material desires, he's in a better position than an impersonalist.Who may have no material desires.
哪怕有着许多物质欲望的奉献者，他们也好过，他们的地位也好过没有物质欲望的非人格主义者。
So both the karmis and the gyanis are distinguished in terms of their freedom from desires.
Karmi 和 Gyani 他们可以从他们摆脱物质欲望的程度来区分，得到区分。
And so also, this is also true for devotees.
对奉献者而言，这也同样适用。
So most Karmis and Gyanis, they will take the path only, they will come to perfection only gradually.
果报工作者和思辨家们，他们只能逐渐地走在这个达到完美的道路上。
And only a few Paramahamsas who are like Gyanis, they can achieve liberation immediately. Only a few.
只有非常少数的。Paramahansa Gyani, 他们能够立即的就达到解脱。
But the devotees, they are sure to get the ultimate perfection.
然而奉献者们 毫无疑问能够达到终极的完美。
But those who have devotion for the Lord is mixed with material desires, they have to become purified.
谁要是对主的心怀奉爱，但仍然有物质欲望的话，他仍然需要得到净化。
Even to enter into the kingdom of God, a devotee who has no material desire still needs to get more purification.
哪怕是已经进入了神的王国，没有物质欲望的奉献者，也仍然需要得到更多的净化。
Yeah, they should never be considered under the laws of the material nature, like the karmis and jnanis.
永远不要以为他们处在物质自然法则的控制之下，就像那些国报工作者和思辨家们一样。
A devotee with no material desires will live happily in this world without material problems.
没有物质欲望的奉献者们会快乐地生活在这世上，他们不会有物质的问题。
And if they want, they can visit all the different regions of the world. They can go to the higher planets.
如果他们有愿望的话，可以拜访这个世上的不同的区域，甚至高等的星球。
And they can also go to the subtle stages of the Achiradi path.
他们也可以去精微的层面，被称为 Achiradi 的层面。
And they can get the Vaikuntha, they can reach the Vaikuntha. There's a Vaikuntha region within this universe, like Sweta Dweep.So they can also go there.
在这个宇宙也有一个外昆特区域，称为 Shita Dweepa， 他们甚至可以去那里。
So because they are pure devotees, they avoid they don't have any miseries of the material world.
因为他们都是纯净的奉献者们，因此他们没有物质世界的痛苦。
And they find happiness even in this world.
哪怕在这个世界，他们也能找到快乐。
So.Even while the devotees are finishing their last enjoyment of the material world, the power of devotional service purifies them.
奉献者们，当他们结束了物质世界的最后的享受的时候，他们就。这是由于奉献服务的力量净化了他们。
Yeah, devotional service is so powerful, it destroys all the obstacles in the devotee's heart.
奉爱服务如此强大有力，能够毁灭奉献者内心的一切障碍。
So when their material business is finished, then they achieve the Lord's eternal abode.
当他们的物质事物已经完结之后，就能真达主永恒的居所了。
Okay, maybe we'll stop here today.
好，那今天我们讲课部分就到这里。接下来如果有问题可以提出来。
Yeah.
Yes. There are still questions from last week.
Okay.
我们先回答上周的问题。仔细明白 Guru， 我工作的地方是供有佛的地方，每天我也需要供香等等，我该如何做好奉献者呢？ So, Guru, the place where I work, there are also altar for Buddha, and they have the Buddha. I need to offer incense to the Buddha. So as a devotee, how can I carry out my duty?
Well, we can consider Buddha also to be the avatar of Lord Vishnu. So when you offer the incense, you think of Lord Buddha as being the avatar of Lord Vishnu.
佛祖也是 Vishnu 的化身，当您供香的时候呢，就把佛祖视为 Vishnu 的 avatar， Vishnu 的化身。下一个问题，聆听的小鱼儿，请问 Guru， 在生活中受到不幸打击的时候，如何重新找回生活的热情？哎，是对吗？Guru, sometimes we have misery in the world. There are some unfortunate events, and we were attacked by this unfortunate events. How can I become enthusiastic once again?
Well, you have to understand that the unfortunate events are over with now. So you should feel glad that your unfortunate events are past. Now you have to go on with your life and make your life fortunate by devotional service. You can feel happy and you can forget the miseries of the material world.
Oh, 现在这些不幸的事件、不幸的打击已经过去了，那你应该为此而感到高兴和快乐，因为这些不幸都烟消云散了。您可以继续生活，然后使通过奉爱服务使您的生活变得幸运起来。所以您要保持快乐，遗忘掉物质世界的种种的痛苦。
Material world, there will always be some unfortunate events. We have to tolerate.
物质世界呢的不幸的事件是层出不穷的，我们要容忍。
We should not become too much disturbed.
我们不要过于受到打扰。
You should think it must have been something to do with your past karma.
So you 要这样想，这也是你过去的 karma， 就过去的活动导致的结果。
So now it's over with.
那现在呢？它已经结束了。
So go on with your life.
你继续生活。
Mm-hmm.
那我们看一下，我们先看有关的问题。Shall we first answer the relevant questions?
嗯哼。
我们先看，这有关的 Yuvati Sachi， 他说 ：“Hare Krishna, dear Gurumar, please accept my humble obeisance of Lord Srila Prabhupada. First, it is believed that.There are a lot of Vaikuntha planets in the spiritual world. What is the difference between them? Yuvati Sachi Devadasa 说，在灵性世界有 有大量的白昆塔星球，它们有什么区别？
Well, on different planets, the Lord is worshipped in different forms and in different pastimes.
在不同的白昆塔的星球，主他以不同的形象上演着不同的逍遥时光。
For example, Lord Kapila has a planet where he resides there with his mother, Devahuti.
例如，有一个白昆的星球呢，主卡皮拉的 Dev 就和他的母亲 Devahuti 居住在那里。
And grandfather Bhishma, he resides in a Vaikuntha planet where Lord Krishna is the chariot driver of Arjuna.
老祖父 Bhishma, 他也生活在一个百昆特星球。在这个百昆特星球呢，主 Krishna 呢，作为 Arjuna 的战车御者，就在那里。
Okay.
第二 ，Can people hear?
嗯。
How can people hear Paramatma's voice? How can we not confuse the voice of the Paramatma with different lower entity? 他第二问题，人们能不能听到超灵的说话？他们怎么才不把超灵的声音和低等的生物体的声音混为一谈。
Well, they have to want to hear. They have to be willing to hear from the Paramatma. The Lord is speaking to everyone, but not everyone's willing to hear.
他们必须想有这个愿望，想要听到超灵讲话，主他就和我们在讲话，但是有人就不想听。
So, we have to understand some people are not willing to be receptive. They don't want to hear. Even though the Lord is speaking to them, they don't want to hear. So nothing can be done.
那么这样的人，有的人呢，他就是不愿意接受超灵的训示，他就是不想听主，他在和这样的人讲话，但是他不想听，没办法。第三个 ，We should not criticize the devotees, but we should choose who to follow.To follow, we must distinguish who is more strict in his sadhana and who is less, who understands philosophy better, who is worse. That is, we should understand that some of the devotees may be acting incorrectly. How can we understand the faults of the devotees and yet not criticize them? 第三，我们不应当批评奉献者们。但是呢，我们可以选择去追随哪位奉献者。为了做出正确选择，我们要区分谁的sadhana规范原则更加严格，谁不严格做规范守则，谁理解谁对哲学的理解更好，有的谁理解不那么好。这就是说，我们要明白，有些奉献者他们的行为呢是不正确的，那我们又如何理解奉献者们的错误，然后不批评他们
？Well, we have to look at your own faults, and then you won't think about criticizing others. When you see yourself full of faults, then you'll be careful not to criticize others.
那我们应该想着自己的错儿，我们就当我们想着自己的错儿的时候，就不想批评别人的时候， 批评别人了，因为我们自己是充满了错误，这时候我们就没心情批评别人了。下一个问题是，iPhone Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble business. I am sorry, I have joined a little late, Gurudev. When you mentioned that the person gets self-realized when the subtle body is up there. When the subtle body is up there, can a devotee get self-realized being on this planet? Because that is what we are hoping for, to realize that we are servants of the Lord. Can we purely get that realization being on Earth?
Yes, you can.
这位奉献者说，我来的有点晚，您提到当精微躯体就是消融之后，人就得到了自我觉悟，那当人可不可以在这个星球上得到自我觉悟呢？我们都渴望得到自我觉悟，意识到我们是主的仆人，能不能达到这个纯粹的觉悟呢？在地球上，那老师说可以，
But you have to follow the process strictly.
但是您必须非常严格的来遵守这个程序。
You want to get the best results, so you follow, do everything you're supposed to do.
倘若您要得到最好的结果的话，就应该去做您理应当做的事情。
OK。
这位昆扎玛拉说：“明白，请问，是不是只有地球上的人的躯体才可以觉悟，去到外昆的？如果是天堂星球的人，或者是 Rakshasi、Asura， 他们可以觉悟，回到外昆的吗？” My question is that.Is that whether or not that only the soul in a human body on the earth can become self-realized and go to Vaikuntha if they are residents of the heavenly planets or Rakshasi or Asura, can they become realized and go back to Vaikuntha?
Yes, they can.
可以。
But it's more difficult.
但是难度要更大。
The attraction in the heavenly planets with so much sense gratification, it's very difficult to give it up.
因为在天堂星球，感官享乐的吸引力这么大，很难放弃。
And in the lower regions, there's so much suffering.You just want to get relief from the suffering.
在低等的区域呢，然后满是苦，受苦。那时候人的一心想要摆脱的是痛苦。
But they can also go back to Godhead gradually.
但他们可以逐渐的回归神手。
But the devotee can go back to Godhead immediately.
奉献者们却可以立刻的就回归。
So that's a special facility of the Earth planet.
这就是地球这个星球可以提供的良好的、好的、便利的设施。
So you find even demigods want to come to this planet because in the Kali Yuga it's so easy to become self-realized.
半神人们呢也想要来到这个地球星球，因为在卡利年代很容易就可以得到自我觉悟。
Yes, okay.
下一个， Rajendra Prabhu has raised her his hands. 那您说 ，Rajendra Prabhu。
Hare Krishna Maharaj， 谢谢你的讲课。我刚才听到您讲课中说，乌塔拉说，奉献者有物质欲望时得到满足，然后净化回灵世界。我的问题是，奉献者的物质欲望是如何得到满足的呢？ Krishna 是怎么满足奉献者的物质欲望的呢？谢谢您。
Well.How does Krishna satisfy the material desires of the devotee? It will depend what their material desires are. Sometimes, you know, just like Dhruva Maharaj wanted to be the king of a kingdom. And so Krishna arranged that he would go there to the pole star and live there and become, even before that, he became the king. He ruled the earth for thousands of years. And then he went to the pole star.And he resided there for a long time.
这要是奉献者的物质欲望是如何的？比如说，朱文玛拉这一心想要当国王，所以主就安排他在地球上呢，也统治了很长的时间，漫长的时间之后，又去了北极星，在那里统治。
So you get you have your desires. Some, of course, if the desire is detriment of is something which is not for our development in Krishna consciousness, if it's against the path of devotion, then Krishna will help us to purify that desire.
但倘若这位奉献者的愿望是不利于发展 Krishna 之觉的，是违背了奉爱服务的原则的话， Krishna 就会帮助这位奉献者净化他的欲望。
But devotees will have, you know, the desires of devotees are special. Like sometimes devotee couples, they want to have a son. They want to have a son who is a great devotee of Krishna. Also, Krishna may arrange.
奉献者们，有的奉献者有着特殊的愿望，比如说奉献者的夫妇想要有一个伟大奉献者的儿子， Krishna 就会安排。
Sutapa and Prishni, they did austerities to get the Lord as their son for 3 births.
Sutapa 和 Prishni 这对夫妻呢，从事严苛的苦行，他们最后得到主三世成为他们的儿子。
Yeah, so devotees can have material desires, but Krishna can satisfy them for them.
So, from these examples, it can be seen that even if the volunteer has a material desire, Krishna will satisfy it.
Some material desires may take longer to fulfill.
有的物质愿望满足有的奉献的物质欲望呢，需要花很长的时间。
Maybe even the desire may not be fulfilled in this lifetime. We may have to take another birth in order to fulfill our material desire.
也许在这一生呢，他们的物质欲望还没有满足，他们必须要再次投生，来世满足他们的物质欲望。
OK,
我能不能再问最后一个问题 ，Guru Mani？
当然。
那个我们都建议奉献者直接重返家园，回归守身 ，Go back home, back to Godhead。但我们回去的路上路过天堂，比如说什么那个 Mahaloka、Mahaloka、Jnanaloka、Tapaloka 和 Brahmaloka。但奉献者肯定是不想在那，但如果奉献者特别好奇，想看看这些天堂是什么样子，想去溜溜弯儿，去转一转， 然后回归守神。如果有这样的思想，妈呀，你会觉得怎么样？亏算能不能满足这样奉献者的愿望？只是看一下。谢谢你。
Yes, it happens. The whole Brihad Bhagavatamrita is about that. It's about Gop Kumar and how he, you know, visited all these different places. So it's certainly possible for devotees that you can go off, you can go into these places and you can delay going back to Godhead.
在整部大波大瓦坛，高帕库马尔的旅行的过程当中呢，就体现了这一点。高帕库马尔就拜访了这不同的地方。所以呢，奉献者他们，会偶尔，中途半道上他们去别的地方，所以他们回归神守的时间呢就延迟了。
OK, go, 继续。
下一个，Mada Veda Devadasi 瓦坛中说，十四个星系中，地球处于中间，位于至尊主的腰部。为何 Maitreya 说地球出自至尊主的腿部？In Srimad Bhagavatam, it mentions among the 14 planetary system, the Earth is situated in the middle, on the waist of the Supreme Lord. Then why Maitreya Muni said the Earth comes from the leg of the Supreme Lord?
I don't know, I haven't got this fully. Can you have to tell me again?
She said that there's contradiction in Srimad Bhagavatam about the earth. When in one place it says the earth is situated in the waist of the Supreme Lord, but in another place it says, Maitreya says the earthcomes from the leg of the Supreme Lord. So there are contradictions.
Well, you get different descriptions of the universal form. They're describing the universal form of the Lord. So you get different descriptions, but the leg, it can be, you know, it can be the top, it could be the thigh, it could be the leg. You say the waist, not such a big difference.Just try to understand the picture of the universal form. You know, detail some little differences may be there. There's different descriptions of the universal form. You just have to accept that.
这些都是对主的宇宙形象的描述。在不同的地方呢，就对有的说呢是他的。地球是他主至尊主的大腿，在那个地方，是不同的区域，在另一个地方是另一个区域，所以这些呢，都是对于主的至尊主的宇宙形体的这个描绘，细节上会有差别，都是对于宇宙形象的描述，所以我们要只要接受就好了，不用过于纠结细节。
Different people will see the form in different ways.
不同的人以不同的方式看待主的宇宙形象。
Go ahead.
好，下一个。那我们就从头开始回答问题。下一个问题是。2500顶 Hare Krishna， 请问 Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti 是从稳定阶段到依恋阶段吗？ The question is that the Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti is between the Nishtha stage and the Asakti stage.
Yes.
是的。 下一个 Shuti Rupa Devi Dasi， 明白亲爱的 Guru Devi 老师，我们到南宁了，昨晚和其他修行的朋友一起唱诵时，他们都泣不成声，泪流满面。他们提问说，为什么一唱 Krishna 的名字就哭泣？为什么跟着集体唱诵不如自由发挥唱诵更有感情？感恩您。 Shuti Rupa Devi Dasi is asking yesterday we have already arrived at Nanning yesterday night. I chanted with the other friends and they all cried and shed incessant tears. So they are asking why they are crying once they are chanting the name of Krishna.
Why are they crying? Maybe they're yes. very sentimental.
他们哭泣呢，有可能是因为他们特别感情用事。
Tell them to try to chant more and cry less.
告诉他们要多念诵，要少哭。
多唱诵。
多唱诵啊、，sorry， 多唱诵。They are asking.
Yeah.
During the kirtan, sankirtan.
Yeah.
Why? During the sankirtan, they are less sentimental than when they are freely.Chanting. The question is why? Why?
Well, Sankirtan.
When they are.
Sankirtan is more powerful. It conquers the mind.
就是因为集体唱诵就更能够征服心意。
哈利布。让我们的咕噜队歇一会儿吧，可以吗？
嗯，不要，我们继续。
下一个问题，关景如，我咕噜，我们不是这躯体，是灵魂，那灵魂又是什么？灵魂是谁？咕噜 ，we are not this material body, we are soul. What does the soul looks like? And who is the soul?What is the soul?
We are, every living entity individually is a soul.
我们就是所有的生物体，所有的生物个体都是灵魂。
The soul is different from the material body. The material body takes birth and dies.But the soul never dies and it never takes birth. It's eternal.
物质躯体会出生，物质躯体会死亡。然而，灵魂不会出生，灵魂也不会死亡。灵魂是永恒的。
Yeah. So you have to understand there's, beside the material energy, there's a spiritual energy.An energy which is different from what you've ever understood before.
要明白，在有物质能量的存在，也有灵性能量的存在。灵性能量和我们之前的理解是迥然不同的。
So we are.Every individual, we're all individuals, we all have our own individual identity, and that identity is there in the soul.
We have our own identity. Our identity is in the soul.
So this soul.Is in a form of spiritual energy. It's a very minute size. It's 1/10,000th of the tip of the hair, and it's situated in the heart. So sometimes we ask people, what is the difference between the living body and the dead body? And the difference is that in the dead body there is no soul. When the soul leaves the body is a dead body.
有时候我们会询问人们，那到底一个活着的躯体和一个死尸有什么区别？区别就是死尸它已经没有灵魂了，一旦灵魂离开了躯体，那这个躯体就变成具尸体。
So, because of our ignorance, we identify ourselves with the material body, the physical body. But this physical body is just a covering of our real self.
出于愚昧，我们会认同于当下的这个物质躯体，把这个物质躯体当成是真我，认为它是真正的自我。
We have a material gross body, we also have a material subtle body, which is made up of the mind and the intelligence and the false ego.
我们不仅除了有物质的粗糙的躯体之外，还有物质的精微的躯体是由心意、智性、假我组成。
Everyone has a mind and intelligence and some ego. You don't see it, they're subtle, but they're there with every individual.
我们看不见我们的精微躯体，这精微躯体是由心意，有着心意，也有着智性，还是有着一个假我，每个人。
So finer than the subtle body, there's a spiritual body.
比精微躯体更加精细的，更加精妙的呢，是灵性的身体。
Our spiritual body is contained within the spirit soul.
我们的 Our spiritual body is contained within the spiritual soul. 我们的灵性的身体呢，是包含在灵魂之内的。
So when we finish, when we get free of, totally free of karma, we'll give up our physical body and we'll give up our subtle body and we'll have our spiritual body.
当我们已经完全的 免除了karma因果之后，我们就会放弃粗糙的躯体，也会放弃精微的躯体，我们会得到一具灵性的身体。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于乌米拉贝达西，不对，这个讲课有百度繁盘的群有。 请您联系主持人。下一个问题，我是来自于，马大卫，请问卡皮拉的父亲为什么要在主出生后就离家去森林苦修？就在主就在他家里显现，他为什么不直接服务主而去森林苦修呢？
Why the father of Lord Kapila left home
after the Lord, after her son is born and go to the forest to do tapasya. Although the Lord was appeared in his own home, why he didn't serve the Lord instead going to the forest to do tapasya?
Yes, because it shows the example that you have to detach from the home.
这个原因就是因为卡皮勒的父亲要做出表率和榜样，他要离开妻姐家庭。
You have to follow the Vedic system. After Grihastha life, then you leave the wife in the care of the son, and then the father can go out, the husband can go, and he can completely devote himself to the service of the Lord.
这就是伟达的制度，伟达的体系是居士他要将妻子留给长大成人的儿子照顾，然后丈夫就要启程，将自己完全奉献给对主的服务。
OK。
下一个问题是，这位一串 Redmi 红米手机。基督教徒说的神与 Krishna 有什么关系？另一个问题，我们说的大道至简中的道与 Krishna 有何关系？ What's the relationship between God in Christianity and Krishna?
Well,in Christianity, it could be the same. It depends on what the Christian thinks, how the Christian think of God. Different Christians have different ideas. Some people think Jesus is God, but Jesus never said that he was God. He said, worship my Father. And he said, I sit on the right hand side of my Father.But many Christians, they think that Jesus is God.
这要取决于不同的基督徒对于神的想法和概念。他们有对神有着不一样的概念。有的人认为耶稣基督本人就是神，但是耶稣说要崇拜我的父亲，我就坐在我父亲的右手。然而许多人还把他当成神。
So if we understand that Jesus is a teacher and he's teaching us how to love God, then there's no difference.
倘若我们把耶稣基督当成老师，他在教导世人如何去爱神，如果我们是这样的想法，那就是这那就没有什么区别了。
There's one God.
只有一位神。
He has many different names.
他有许许多多的名字。
So we call God by the name Krishna, meaning all attractive. The Christians may call God by the name Jehovah or other names, I don't know. But it's one God. There's only one God. And real religion is to love God.
我们称神为 Krishna, 是因为他是最有吸引力的人。基督教里称神上帝为耶和华。但是神只有一位，真正的宗教就是教导人们怎么去爱神。
However, we do stress that love of God means we should love also his parts and parcels.And that doesn't allow us to have slaughterhouses and to kill animals just for our food.
然而我们确实也强调爱神就要爱神的所属部分，他的 body 和碎片， 不应该去维持屠宰场，去屠宰那些动物作为盘中餐。
So before we try to discuss philosophy with Christian people, we first of all, they have to agree that that eating of meat is wrong, and particularly killing of the cows is wrong.
在和基督徒讨论哲学之前呢，基督徒们首先要同意杀动物。吃动物的肉是错误的，尤其是吃牛肉是错的。Then the next part of the question is, what's the relationship between the Tao? There's a phrase that is called.The Tao is very simple. The big Tao is very simple. What's the relationship between the Tao in this phrase with Krishna?
Well, I'd have to know more about what is that teaching of the Tao.
那么您要就是您所说的这个道，它的是哲理，您要更再细啊，详细的再说一些。
Generally, we find that what these other different paths that they don't have any personal feature of God, but they simply talk about the impersonal aspect.
我们通常发现，在这个。别的种类的教导当中呢，不存在就是神的人格的教导，对神的人格化的教导，只有描述的是神的非人格的特征。
And sometimes even they just only give importance to just moral principles, cultivating good habits and practicing moral behavior.
常常呢。有的只是在强调，一味的强调道德原则，教导人们要培养好的习惯，要践行德行。
That may be nice philosophy, but it's not religion.
他们也许是很好的哲学，有着很好的哲理，但是不是宗教。
There has to be both philosophy and religion together.
那他们既要有哲学，也要有宗教，要两个都二者兼有，二者兼容。
There should be some concept of God at some particular level of understanding that there's a creator behind this world.
一定要有神的概念，就是在特定的层面上呢，要承认在这世界的背后存在着一个创造者。
OK。
好，下一个问题是，答 S， 请问 Guru， 瑜伽师到了超龄也是非人格的吗 ？Guru。Even if the yogis, they have attained the super soul, is that impersonal?
Well, it depends on what is their realization of the super soul. If they think they have become the super soul, then it's impersonal. But if they understand that they are the servant of the super soul and they surrender to the super soul and do service, then that is not impersonal. Then that is devotion.
这要取决于这位瑜伽师的觉悟，对于超龄的觉悟。如果他是认为自己已经成为了超龄的话，就是非人格的。那倘若他要是认识到他是超龄的仆人，应当臣服于超龄， 做服务的话，那就不是非人格的，而是奉爱服务了。下一个，聆听。非奉献者接受免费的 prasadam， 有没有业报？
免费的 prasadam means there's no karma， 没有业报。
没有，prasadam 它就意味着就是没有业报。
If it's actually prasadam, then there's prasadam means karma free.
如果是真的真正的 prasadam， prasadam 的意思就是，无业报的食无业报食品。
嗯。
下一个，仍然是这位大 S Madhva 的哲学是什么？Madhva， what is？The philosophy of Madhva.
Madhva Acharya. We are coming in the line of Madhva Acharya.
我们就是隶属于 Madhva Acharya 这个使徒传系。
So he gave great importance to defeating Mayavadi philosophy.
Madhvacharya 非常的强调要打败，假象宗的哲学。
Even today they have schools in South India which teach the philosophy of Madhvacharya.
时至今日，在南印度仍然有 Madhvacharya 的教导 Madhvacharya 哲学的学校。
They have to learn.How to argue and defeat Mayavadi philosophy.
在这所学校当中，学生们要学习如何，如何去争论，据理力争，打败假象宗的哲学。
Madhva also worshipped the deity of Lord Krishna as a person.
Madhvacharya 也把 Krishna 的神像，也崇拜 Krishna 的神像，也。去当作人格去崇拜。
Those are the two main aspects of Madhvacharya's philosophy.
这就是 Madhvacharya 哲学的两个重要组成部分。
下一个问题。
下一个，柴心童，请问 Guru， 就想回答文达本这个想法对吗？还是应该只想着服务 Krishna？听从 Krishna 的安排，哪个对？She's asking which idea is right, which desire is right. Only wholeheartedly want to go back to Vrindavan. The other is to think about serve Krishna and follow the arrangement of Krishna. Which is right?
Well, both are right.
都对。
You cannot say one is wrong, both right.
不能说哪个是错的，都是正确的。下一个 ,Das, 天地 Indra 也统治太阳星球吗？哪个级别高？ Does Lord Indra also rule over the sun planet?
Lord Krishna rule over the sun planet?
Lord Indra, yes, and which is higher, which is superior?
Sun planet is superior.
太阳星球更级别高。
It's above Indra, above the heavenly planets. Well, Sun planet is also a heavenly planet, but the sun planet is of the sun god is a very superior. It's, you know, he's not going to be under the control of Indra. Sun, generally we say the sun and the moon are heavenly planets. So they're in heaven, but they're somewhat independent of Indra.
Indra的统治之下，他们是独立，太阳是独立的。 Next one， 下一个，西西，灵魂在心脏部位，那心脏移植手术，心脏换了，原来灵魂还在吗？ 嗯。 What about the heart surgery? If the one had this surgery and replace the heart with another one heart, does the soul also live there in the region?
Yeah, the same soul, you just have a different seat. The heart is like the seat, just like if you change the seat in a car. The driver is the same driver, but you have a different seat. So the heart is like the seat. So it's the same person, just with he's got a different seat.
这个就好像司机的座椅，他换了一个座椅，但是司机还是同一个司机，心脏换了一个心脏，但是还是同一个座椅，这个灵魂只是座椅换了，但是灵魂还是同一个灵魂。 亲爱的Guru，我希望我的服务是有爱心的，可是心意很疯狂，我对我的服务总是打问号，该怎么做？ I hope my service is out of devotion, but my mind is crazy. I'm always doubtful about my service. What should I do?
Well, you should chant Hare Krishna more. You have to absorb your mind in hearing the holy name and try to engage yourself more in devotional service. Keep yourself busy. Everyone's crazy in this material world. Everyone has a crazy mind. So we have to keep ourselves always busy in devotional service, and that will control the mind.
您需要更多的念诵、唱诵 Hare Krishna， 专心的聆听圣灵，从事于忙于奉爱服务。在物质世界，每个人都是疯狂的，都有着疯狂的心意。您要让您的心意忙于奉献服务，从而控制心意。 下一个 ，Galaxy 80A80， 马拉，听说要会四种瑜伽的融合才能完美，这种说法对吗？比如说思辨瑜伽、奉爱瑜伽、体式瑜伽。马拉，Galaxy is paid business. I heard that one has to master four kind of yoga to achieve perfection. Is this statement right? For example, Dhyana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, and Asana Yoga.
Asana Yoga?
Ashtanga Yoga.
Ashtanga Yoga?
体式瑜伽.
And what is she saying? That by Ashtanga Yoga?
interesting. I heard that one has to know to know how to combine four kinds of yoga. After that, can achieve a perfection.
Well, yes, but we don't have to practice all of the different yogas. You just simply have to practice bhakti yoga. And by doing bhakti yoga, then you also acquire knowledge about the other different yoga processes.
您不需要修习修炼不同种类的瑜伽，只要修炼芭提瑜伽、凤爱瑜伽，就可以达到别的种类的瑜伽的知识了。
Just like karma yoga, so karma yoga is to teach us to work and to be detached from the results.
例如说 karma yoga， 活动瑜伽。 他就是在教导我们该如何工作，并且要弃绝工作的结果。
So a devotee works like that. A devotee is working, he's not attached to the result. He gives the result to Krishna.
奉献者就是这样子，奉献者们工作，但是却不依附工作的结果，他们把结果献给Krishna。
And then Dhyana Yoga. Dhyana Yoga means you have knowledge. So a devotee also has knowledge. He's regularly hearing the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. He's hearing more and more about Krishna, Krishna's energies.
那至于Dhyana Yoga知识瑜伽呢，就奉献者们他们也不缺知识，他们总是在聆听国家梵歌、圣典布达瓦坛，越来越多的聆听，因此便获得有关 Krishna 以及 Krishna 能量的知识了。
And then if you do Ashtanga Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, devotees, that's meditation, concentration of the mind on the Supreme. So a devotee doing Bhakti Yoga, he always remembers Krishna.
那至于 Ashtanga Yoga, Babu Yoga, 以及 Dhyana Yoga, 禅定瑜伽的话，那奉献者们呢，他们也总是在处在 冥想当中，专心致志的想着至尊主，所以他们自动的就想着Krishna了。
So by Bhakti Yoga, all the four yogas are also there in Bhakti Yoga. All the other yogas are there.
奉爱瑜伽就包含了所有种类的其他的瑜伽形式了。
Just like you like to do asanas, you like to do different exercises. So when you do worship of Krishna, we bow up, we bow down, and we stand up, and we jump and dance. We do a lot of exercises.
谁要是喜欢阿萨呢，这个体式瑜伽呢，或者喜欢做锻炼的话，让他们崇拜 Krishna， 他们就会礼拜 Krishna， 然后。 或者是站起身，或者是跳跳跃，或者是舞蹈，他们自动的就锻炼了，有着这些提示了。
Okay。
下一位，Madhavi，明白Guru，八瓦阶段的人不受Maya的影响，为何还会堕落？Bharata王已经处于八瓦阶段，为何受到鹿的吸引？ 是由于吸引的吸引的衣服吗？他投生为鹿是堕落的表现吗？So Guru, one who is situated in the stage of Bhava will not be affected by Maya. Then why, he also fall down? For example, Bharat Maharaj has already situated in the stage of Bhava. Then why he was attracted by a deer? Is that due to the attachment of the mind? He has took birth as a deer. Is it a symptom of falling down?
Yes, it's a fall down.
是的，这个是确实是一种堕落。
become overly attached to an animal.
过分的依附动物。
Then he had to take birth again.
以至于他不得不再次投生。
So even though you come to the stage of bhava, doesn't mean you always stay on the stage of bhava. You can fall back down if you're not careful, if you don't have association.
即便一个人已经来到了bhava阶段，并不意味着他就能恒常的留在这个阶段，他可能会再度堕落回你下面低等的阶段。如果他对于联谊的对象不小心的话，不小心选择联谊对象。
So Bharat Maharaj didn't have any association. That was, and then he took association from a deer. So he left the bhava platform.
由于 Bharat Maharaj 他没有联谊，所以呢，他导致了他和一头动物联谊，使得他就离开了bhava的层面。
Okay.
下一个问题是道。So the Redmi, this devotee, is asking the Tao. This devotee is saying the Tao is in the Tao De Jing, the Sutra of Taoism.
Yes.
So what's the relationship between this Tao and Krishna?
Well, what's the relationship? This Tao is giving some aspect of Krishna's different energies. One tiny portion of the feature of Krishna. Everything is Krishna. All the knowledge is also coming from Krishna. So Taoism is one part of something which has come from Krishna, but it's not the complete perfection.
Mm-hmm. 道德经里的讲的是涉及到了 Krishna 的不同的能量，它只是一小部分的能量，也涉及到了 Krishna 的特征，一切都是 Krishna， 一切的知识是来自于 Krishna 的。道德经里的这个知识是不完美的知识，它只是部分的知识。
It will keep you in the modes of nature. You'll still be in the mode of, you may come to the mode of material goodness, but you're still under on the material platform. You have not transcended.
他仍然会将人束缚在 Krishna 的自然物质自然本性当中，可能能将人提升到物质的善良属性，但是这仍然是处在物质的层面，没有达到超人的层面。
OK。
下一个，开心周美红，明天清明，请问是否可以用婆沙的拜祭？听说供奉亡灵的祭品是属于愚昧形态、愚昧属性，我们是不能吃的，祭品怎么处理？Obeisance to Guru, tomorrow is 清明 festival. My question is that whether or not can we do worship the relative who has passed away by prasadam. I heard that the offering to the souls who have passed away is in the mode of ignorance. We cannot eat that. So how can we deal with those offerings?Oblations.
Well, the offerings, they can be offered to the, you can offer them to the trees, you can offer them to the plants, offer them back to the earth.
这些祭品可以 给树或者是给植物，也可以把它们重新让它们再回归大地。
The birds, so many different living entities are there. They will eat.
还有鸟类，还有各种各样的生物体都可以吃这些祭品。
Okay.
潘知道了吧 ？Thank you so much for your Radhananda, Hare Krishna. 顶拜亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 请问已经接受 ISKCON Guru 启迪的奉献者。没有办法读懂国家放歌原意，却热衷于花钱去听别人讲的《道德经》或《易经》，这样下去还能守住 Krishna 之觉吗？这样的门徒会妨害到灵性导师吗？非常感谢。Radhananda Maharaj is asking, although some devotees have been initiated by Guru in ISKCON, but still cannot understand Bhagavad Gita and will pay money.To others to listen to, the 道德经 the Sutra of 道德经 or 易经 In that case, can this devotee still, fixed in Krishna consciousness, and will that, affect his or her spiritual master, or do be detrimental to the spiritual master? Thank you.
Well, he's not, if he's doing things like listening to Dao De Jing and contributing financial support to it, he's not in Krishna consciousness. These are not Krishna conscious activities.
如果就是他这么去做，然后花钱支持这个道德经的事业，就不是 Krishna 之觉，不是 Krishna 之觉的活动。
And the spiritual master, it depends how much the spiritual master cares about that disciple. If that disciple has given up the relationship with the spiritual teacher, then the spiritual teacher doesn't suffer any reaction.
至于就是他对灵性导师没有妨害的话，这取决于，他对就是灵性导师这位门徒的，依赖程度。如果这个灵导师，对于这位门徒的关心程度，如果这已经放弃了这种灵性的关系的话，就不受这个活动的影响了。
If he's actually accepting the spiritual master, he has to follow the instructions of the spiritual master.
倘若这奉献者已经接受了灵性导师的训示的话，就应该去遵循奉行灵性导师的训示。
OK。
下一个问题，Guru， 我们如何从粗糙躯体、心意躯体到灵性躯体，是通过做奉爱服务吗 ？Guru， how can we, migrate from the gross physical body and subtle body to spiritual body? Is that through devotional service?
Yes.
是的。
Okay, how many more questions?
One more.
Okay, 最后一个问题。
好的，Lupi, good day, 我亲人我把他出钱喂牛，可以净化他们的业力吗？还是必须他们自己出钱才能净化业力吗？For my relatives, can I pay money to feed the cow, to purify their karma, or they have to pay for themselves to purify their karma?
Well.Purifying their karma, it's not just only paying money to the cows, there's more to it than that.
净化业力可不仅仅是只要出钱喂养母牛就净化了，不止这个。
If they still eat cows, then they're not going to get rid of their karma.
Oh, 如果这样的人他们还在吃牛肉的话，那怎么能净化业力呢？
So they have to follow the religious principles and chant the holy name. Then they can really purify their karma.
他们必须要遵守宗教的原则，唱诵圣名，才能够真正的净化掉业力。
But still, if you want to pay money for the cows, it's very nice. It's a pious activity. Cows are very dear to Lord Krishna.
倘若他想要喂养母牛的话，也是很好的，这是虔诚的活动，因为母牛是 Krishna 非常钟爱的。
Okay. So,
okay.
What was?
咕噜对。还有一个举手的叫哈利尼，你们看见了吗？他始终举着手。
Oh yes, Halini has already raised her hand for a long time.
Yeah, okay. So what's your question?
Halini, 那您开麦。
哈利宝，就是请问咕噜，就是我是一个比较愚笨的人。那我在做父爱服务当中呢，我就只是按照就是咕噜的训示经典来做每天的崇拜啊，供奉菩萨的，吃菩萨的，念诵圣名啊。那我这样子的话，我只是做了一个平庸的一个奉献者的服务，我能不能回到灵性世界呢？临终离开的时候。
Yes, you can. You can go back to Godhead at the end of this life, but you have to be fully attached to Krishna.
您可以回，在这生命结束的时候是可以回的，但是需要全心全意的依附于 Krishna。
You're doing the right things. You just have to keep doing them.
您做的是正确的事情，您只需要坚持不断的继续去做下去。
And do them with love, with pure love.
并且是怀着纯粹的爱去做这些事情。
Okay.
明白咕噜队的莲花
组，
感恩咕噜队的回答。
Hare Krishna. Okay, thanks Guru Mani. Thanks all the devotees. Hope you have a good week. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai. Thank you, Maharaj. 外坤在听服务员听，我们非常非常感谢圣 Bhakti Vinashna Singha Maharaj 给我们带来精彩的早课。